And we should go, they cannot be left out. So we as Nigerians, I want to say, I personally share the pains of Nigerians, and it is high time we must bring in solution to this first scarcity of a teen and the hike. So you can look at now, some people were contacting me, what should we do about this issue of fuel hike, the rate at which they are selling. I said, oh, are you even still getting the fuel? When you are talking of hike, you must talk of availability first.
Yes.
Is the fuel even available before you talk of the hike in price? So they must see reasons why solution must come with immediate effect. And by so doing, when there's no power, the next thing you want to look at, you want to see how you can power your generator. And there's no hope as well. And yes. it's as if Satan has even opened the hell, and the heat is so much that we cannot even comprehend it. So the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria should consider it necessary by, I would have said, even declare emergency in that petroleum ministry. But I still want to believe and hope that there can be solution to this problem if adequate and necessary concentrations are given to it.
You did mention the president there, and I want to move on now from the fuel issue. I mean, if we go on that, it just brings back very bad memories for me. But let's move on now to Mr. President. It's Easter Sunday, and he did give an address today, and there's not a lot of punchlines in the speech, but he made mention of the fact that the change that his administration has promised will surely come to fruition. It's going to be a year in government for him in a couple of months, about 2 months or so. Is one year fair enough to be judging him as harshly as we probably are?
Well, I don't think it's fair enough to expect physical manifestations, you know, but it's long enough for us to start expecting or to have the hope that, well, things have been... Things are already set in place and we should be getting results, you know, tangible results. The president will... March 28th is going to be a year after his election.
March 28th,
a year after that is in 2 days' time. It's going to be a year after the election. So I want to start I want to look at his being in office from then, you know, though not constitutional. But I think in the past 1 year, the kind of hope and the followership that Nigerians have given to this government, you know, is one that... Well, it's unprecedented anyway in a democratic setting, perhaps in our own generation. So I think the president, from his statement and everything he has said, I think he has he was trying to appeal to Nigerians. Though in the statement, he appreciated what is going on, you know, and at the point he said it was not a joke, you know, in his last the economic summit, you know, he said it's not a joke, it's not a laughing matter what we are having in this country right now, the economic situation in the country. So we have a lot of issues, you know, the economy, security, you know, power and the rest of them. But the president from his statement is showing a kind of sense of belonging that, well, I appreciate what is going on. I appreciate you people, your support and so on. But keep faith. You could see the outline of his statement. Keep faith and actually trying to trying to appeal to Nigerians to still keep that spirit flying, you know, because there is nothing perfect anywhere.
Yeah.
You know, so from going by the statement of the president and everything that he has done so far, you know, the commitment has been coming up. There are a lot of criticism, traveling around, going here and there, insensitivity to the plight of the masses.
But some
of these things are beginning to yield results. So he's only asking for patience and a little more time. You know,
yeah.
I think the 4 year interval, the 3 more years that he has in the administration is going to bring fruition. He also made mention of the fact that the present budget that was passed by the House of Assembly some couple of days back is the first of his administration. So I think Nigerians should
wait and see how that's
implemented. And see how he does his how he does his thing, how he implements the budget, and rate him on that.
But the speech, like I said, it covered most of the major issues: security, the economy, like you just mentioned. But some people have said there was nothing personal about the budget, you know, about the speech, I beg your pardon, where, I mean, we know how insecurity has been the last couple of months. We hear about the killings in Agatu. We're hearing about bombing still in the Northeast, with the Biafra issues going on, you know, the fuel issues going. These are things that are very, very important to Nigerians right now, but there was no mention of any sort of specific issues. It just glossed over general topics. Do you think that was a problem?
Well, in my candid opinion, it is a very serious problem. Because Nigerians would expect that even while they are given the necessary support, change comes with hope. And like I said earlier, palliative measures are very, very necessary. The present administration, I must tell you, endurance by Nigerians is not the problem. Nigerians are ready to endure because we know how bad the country has been. But yet, some issues of greater concerns are expected to have been addressed. Like we have talked about the fuel issue. We are talking of the Agatu killings. We are talking of the elections in the
River State.
And the state of INEC as a whole, inconclusiveness here and there. These are issues of great concerns. These are issues of human rights that needed to have been addressed even by the president.
Well, at least mentioned.
So one would expect that the president addressed this and just keeping silent and conversing for time, have faith in me. These are Nigerians are already having faith in the administration. We are ready to give necessary support to the administration. But the major thing is, what affects us immediately that can sustain that spirit of change is expected. But the president never mentioned anything of such. So I would expect the president in other avenues where he have opportunity of addressing Nigeria, he should be able to address some of the. Let us hear the authentic state of the nation from him, authentic responses from him. And by so doing, Nigerians will be very, very okay with him. Nigerians will keep hope, will keep faith in him and trust the administration. We have got no choice. We voted massively to change the administration. And to allow the administration to perform will not be a problem. The issue of budget have just come to stay now. It has just been passed. And I'm telling you, we are keeping so much hope in seeing the implementation, the performance of the budget. The budget of change. So Nigerians are quite waiting so much. And as I said, issues of high sensitivity needed to be addressed.
At least mentioned.
The Agatu killings.
Yes.
You are still seeing several forms of threats. It is not good enough for president to just keep silent on issues of such.
Let's talk about Agatu now, because it's something that's not, it didn't start yesterday. It's been going on for a while. It's probably gotten worse recently, and we've seen the former Senate President David Mark making bold statements about it, and visiting and trying to bring it to national discourse and all of that. The government hasn't necessarily said anything. The killings are still going on, and I mentioned Biafra as well. These are things that are boiling in parts of the country, and there seems to be no sort of response from government at all.
Yes, well, you see, this Agatu issue is a very sensitive one, and we really need to condemn these killings in its totality. We have a situation where people, travelers, they move around, the Fulani people that are in question. They move around with their cattle, they are herdsmen, they are not, it's not a place of, it's not their community sort of, they migrate, they are migrants that move around with their cattle, that is their way of life. If they are actually the ones responsible, and we have learned, they are the ones, I think it's quite unfortunate. And we the government needs to stand up at this point in time and take drastic and serious steps to curb this and nip it in the bud. They have claims, what is important to them. Someone actually said, someone that's conversant with the culture of the Fulani said, at the point in time, say they value the life of their cattle, even above that of their children. It's not a statement of fact, but it's one thing that is rumored to be part of the tradition of the Fulani. And if the Fulani are coming out and saying, and their cattle were ambushed, and over 5,000 of their cattle are killed, and they are taking lives, revenge on lives of individuals. This life is not something we should joke about, or something that anyone should politicize. It's something that should be nipped into bud. And I'm so disappointed, or actually looking at a situation, is it possible that the Nigerian military or intelligence body you know, do not have the intelligence, the adequate intel on the movements and the operation of these people.
Yeah.
It's more or less a massacre. And I think it should be looked into. These people can be, we have all sort of apparatus, you know, military-wise and all that, to tackle this issue. If it's going to take physical, if communal or settlement or talking or dialogue cannot settle it, then people should be shown their boundaries. The president said something, or the presidency said something some times ago. He said, well, that in the various states that we should have a ranch, we should have ranch or establish
where
ranch,
they can go and graze,
where they can graze and all that. But these people can't. They would not stay in a place, in a particular place. They move around. They could be in Ilorin today, and by the time you know it, they're already in Adamawa and all that. That is their way of life. So that might not be the solution.
Okay.
You know, but if they are held responsible for whatever, they are given adequate measure of the kind of crime they perpetrated, then I think it's going to teach them a lesson, sort of.
All right, I'm here. We have to go now. Thank you very much for being here today. I know there's always a lot to talk about. Nigeria has like a 1,001 issues just in 1 week. And before we go, I don't know, any sports fans?
Yeah.
Sports fans?
Yeah.
Did you see the Super Eagles game?
Yeah.
What do you think is going to happen against Egypt very quickly?
Well, it's going to be a serious game, and the Super Eagles need to really stand up and get their ass right.
Do you think we can win?
Well, we've done it before. Egypt. We've done it before, and I think it's a good one. We can make it. We can make it. There's going to be a runoff. There's going to be a playoff after one person has qualified.
Okay.
So there's going to be a playoff. So I think Nigeria can still the bottom line is
the equalizer was so heartbreaking.
It was bad.
They can actually
distracted.
They can restore back the hope of Nigerians.
Yeah. And I'm hearing Chad has pulled out of the Nations Cup qualifier. And I also read it this morning that the Egyptian FA board has been disbanded or something. So hopefully that confusion on Tuesday. Thank you very much for being here, mate. Thank you very much, Yinka, for being here today.
Welcome.
We'll come back with more talk right here on Rugby Minds. Please stay with us.